For another great day for basketball. Today, the Humber women's basketball team are going up against the Sheridan Bruins, who are first in the West right now. The game is just about to begin, so moving it over to the commentators. Thank you.
Thank you, Danielle, for that intro. And game already underway here. Quite the matchup for you tonight. My name's Adam Lusher. Here with my broadcasting partner, Andrew Milani, and quite a test for the Hawks tonight as they take on the 4-0 Bruins. See a layup miss there by Taylor. And Andrew, what does Humber have to do in tonight's contest in order to overcome the highest scoring team in all of Ontario in the Sheridan Bruins?
Well, they're going to really have to watch the turnovers here tonight. Sheridan leads the province in steals here. And they're also second last, in turnovers given, so making them second best. Humber being middle of the pack in both those categories. They have to be able to contain the Bruins here tonight.
Absolutely, and there you see the first points of the game dropped there by Humber. Jamie Gordon on the screen as the ball is being moved around the perimeter here. As Giles with it, she puts it up and that'll sink the layup, 4-2 for the Hawks.
Great job by Giles finding the lane for an easy basket there.
And a poor inbound attempt by Orelna LaRoche there for Sheridan as that ball gets away and out of bounds. It'll be Hawks ball. We'll see what this offense could get done.
Been very fast paced here in the early stages of this game. Both teams seem very amped up. This is, of course, a statement game.
There's the replay of that layup made there. It looks like we're ready to get started. Taylor with the inbounds there. Hard on the baseline, trying to get it out to Taylor in 3-point range, unable to do so. Fast break for the Bruins. That layup will not go, and nor will that, as Humber collects the rebound. It's Giles. She works her way back up the court. Finds its way over to Taylor. She'll settle things down. Driving to the lane, up and blocked.
Nice
big block
stop there
by McDonald. As Sheridan now finds themselves pressing back up court. Vallejo there down at the baseline trying to kick out a pass wide, but that toe touched the line to the referee. Now it's up to Jamie Gordon to get this rebound in.
Both these teams here seem like they want to get things going early on. Maybe a little too much. Seeing a little bit of sloppy ball. Oh, man.
And you see it there. That'll be back court violation for Humber. As you showed, Andrew, a little bit of nervousness. Perhaps this is a big game. Sheridan considered one of the biggest rivals for Humber in basketball. We'll see the game, that being the men's contest, go on later tonight at 8 p.m. right here on the Hawk Sports Network.
Yeah, that game promises to be an exciting affair.
Absolutely, but we're not there yet. Is that a little out of bounds on Sheridan? That's McDonald who lost control of that ball. So Humber will have another opportunity to take their first lead in this contest. Inbounded to Taylor. And once again, that pass is deflected, but corralled by Lopez. She'll kick it back out to the top of the key to Jordan. Three put up. No good. That shot coming from Giles. Unable to find the mark. Rebound corralled out there in three-point range. Nice soft pass in there to Maya. And she'll drain that. That's Campbell Johnson, who's been on fire as of late. Couple big points to get things going for Maya Campbell Johnson.
She got things started there with that offensive rebound. She finishes it there. Nice job. Nice hustle.
Campbell Johnson led Humber last game against Lambda with 18 points in that victory. So obviously she's someone that the Hawks want to get going early, as she's been a powerhouse on the offensive side of the basketball this team thus far.
Absolutely.
Substitution here for Sheridan, as we'll see Orellana check out. She's really been key on the rebounding side for Sheridan. She's averaging 11.5 per game for her squad.
It's a bad foul there by Taylor. Can't foul the player on the shoot, on the jump shot, I should say.
Absolutely, that'll put Sheridan on the line. That's Teresa Brown.
And Brown, even though she missed one there, she's a 75% shooter from the line. Definitely not someone you want to send there.
Teresa Brown currently averaging 22.3 points per game. That's good enough for number three in all of the province, so she's not someone you want to give easy points to early, as she nails her second of two free throw attempts.
She almost got a steal there, but Humber gets it in.
Absolutely kicked out wide. Driving the lane, finding a nice pass. Reached in there, but a clean play. So drive buck at the court. Unable to keep it in is Sydney Charvis for Sheridan.
And the turnover parade here continues.
Yeah, we touched on turnovers earlier in the broadcast, and they seem to be rearing their ugly head for both sides so far, as neither team been able to find the rhythm.
Yeah, neither team here really being able to get settled here.
Good ball movement there. Three-pointer put up by Lopez. That won't go. Rebound corralled by Charvis. She'll get things started for the Bruins, driving the lane hard. Puts up a layup, and it'll drop for her. Two big points for Sheridan there as Charvis gets a couple. Maya Johnson looking for the pass before the ball got in her hand there. And she'll let that roll away. It'll be Sheridan basketball.
And what do you know? Another turnover here.
Absolutely. I'm sure head coach AJ Sharma is not going to be too pleased with that so far. It's a little bit of sloppy play so far for the Hawks.
I don't think either coach is going to be pleased with the turnovers here tonight.
Brown with the ball. Kicks it out to number four. That's Charvis. Three put up. No good. Off the side of the rim. Gordon collects the rebound. And she'll bring the Hawks past midcourt. Taylor with the ball now. Finds
Gordon.
Wide open. Great pass there by Taylor. She found Gordon wide open in the key.
Not much to say about that one. Just find your open teammate there right by the rim. Good job.
Nice behind the back move there by Martin. Another long shot attempt by Charvis. That won't go. And Lopez finds her way back up court for Humber. Finds a seam in that defense. Unable to get the fortunate bounce, but she'll collect her own rebound. It's Campbell Johnson. Fires up an air ball. That won't find the rim.
Unfortunate end to that play. Lopez looked really good, got a good shot by the rim, got her own rebound. Ends up leading to an air ball, though.
Yeah, these Hawks players really seem to be buzzing around the rim thus far. Not too much to show for it yet, with just 6 points on the board, a slim 1 point lead over the Bruins early in this contest. And we see Martin, see her drive on Gordon there. That one will roll out, and it's Campbell Johnson on the rebound. Back up to Lopez, quick break here. Pass intended for Gordon, but tipped away by Courtney Martin of Sheridan. That's a nice defensive play.
Good defensive play on both ends there. The Hawks didn't let Courtney Martin get a good shot by the rim there before.
Taylor over to Gordon. Kicks it inside to Lopez. Trying to find Gordon once again, but it's Charvis who intercepts that pass attempt. She'll work her way to the rim. Fouled on the way in, says the referee.
It's going to be a foul on the floor, though, I think. I don't think she'll get shots.
That foul charged to Nikema Taylor. I see Sydney Charvis, who eats up a lot of minutes for the Bruins, check out of this ballgame. Head coach Sean Douglas looking to keep his legs fresh. See that one corralled by Baleja.
Almost another turnover
up
there.
A three. That one nowhere near the mark as Taylor starts the break. Over to Gordon. Attempting to get that pass out on the baseline to Giles in the corner, but that attempted pass goes off the bottom of the backboard. It'll be Bruins basketball.
That was a nice little play there by Lopez. Just that Gordon there couldn't get a handle on it. Ends up leading to another turnover here.
Lopez providing a spark early for the Hawks. As here we see driving, that's number 13, Tamna Rowe. And that shot will sink. Douglas there puts up two for the Bruins, and they regain this lead. Inside to MCJ. Working hard. Puts it up off the backboard, and that won't go. Up to Baleja. And in the paint, that's number 11, Teresa Brown. The big scorer for Bruins, getting on the board early.
Not much Lopez could have done there, just a mismatch. She sinks one for three. Tie game now here, 9-9.
Big shot there by Lopez as she drops that three.
Oh, man.
And quickly returning is Brown. Showing off her shooting prowess. General Lopez finds Giles. Driving hard, fouled on the way in. Shot won't go, but that is a foul. Against number 15, Mara Douglas.
Good job there by Giles to drive into the lane.
See a replay of that shot go in from Lopez. That's a big three-pointer. Jonna Giles hits her first free throw attempt.
And going back to Lopez, she's a 42% shooter from three, so they're going to have to rely on that a lot here tonight if they want to beat the Bruins.
Absolutely, looking to keep pace with this high-powered Bruins offense.
Nice
ball corralled
rebound
there by Beals. Lopez again finds MCJ, battling against two defenders, can't get it to go.
Not a great shot there for CJ in double coverage.
You see Martin here losing control. It's Lopez chasing it down. Nice hustle there. She'll find Brown charging towards the basket. Once again, fouled on the way in by Orelna LaRock.
Not like that hustle there by Leticia Lopez. Really digging in there, finding that ball. Ends up leading to the foul. Nice little series there.
Yeah, and it appears as though both sides trying to find their legs early in this one. Lopez is finding herself all over the floor so far in this contest.
Yeah, she's been a little spark plug here today for the Hawks tonight thus far.
Here we'll see Britannia Brown on the line for Humber as she sinks that one. Brown nearly had a double-double in their last contest against Lambden, finishing with 11 points and 9 rebounds. She'll sink both of those. The inbound coming from Orala.
And Brown is one of those players you definitely don't want to send to the free throw line. She shoots over 83%.
Nice passing there between Ashley McDonald and Tanya Rowe. That's an easy bucket for Sheridan. Ball being circulated around now to Giles. Top of that three-point range. Lopez puts one up, but no shot there as a foul is called on the offense. That one will be charged to Ebony Beals. She'll pick up the offensive foul there. Inbound coming from Ilana Rose Vallejo.
A little too aggressive there.
Ball controlled here on the perimeter. That'll roll off a foot and be collected by Lopez.
That looked like a kick ball, wasn't called though.
Humber has numbers here. Once again, back to Lopez. And another foul charge to Sheridan. That's Vallejo. She's charged with reaching in on Lopez there. It'll be Humber basketball.
It looks like Lopez has been in the middle of everything here today, at least on the offensive end. Really being relied on here by Humber to get some offense going.
Absolutely. Really having her presence felt early on in this contest, and she'll be the one inbounding here. She'll find Giles to Gordon. Over to Brown, back to Giles. Lopez looking to drive here. Puts it off the defender.
Not much time left here on the shot clock. Got to get a quick shot off here.
Absolutely, so it's up to Jonna Giles here. Looking to find someone open on the inbound. Just 6.4 remaining on the shot clock. And now we're not inbounded cleanly. Giles lasts that one off, ready to get things going here. Just 5.7 remaining on that shot clock. Looking to get something done quick. That's into Beals. Tipped away. It'll be Sheridan basketball. See Ashley McDonald coming and get this one started. Risky pass there, but that's collected by Charvis. A foul called there.
Been the definition of a back and forth game here. Really none of these teams being able to get some momentum going, just really going back and forth. Not that we've seen the lead over two here so far, or at least over three, sorry.
Yeah, exactly what we expected from an always tightly contested Sheridan and Humber rivalry. That's just a 1-point lead here for the Bruins as Giles chucks up a three. No good. That'll clank off the rim.
Still good shot selection, though.
Nice save by Beals. Kicks it through the legs, but no Hawk was there to take it. So now it's McDonald getting things started for the Bruins. Vallejo charging the lane. Little floater won't go. She battles her way down under the rim for that rebound, and she'll draw a foul. So Lopez, the name we've been saying all night so far, was charged for the foul there. I'll put Vallejo on the line.
Yeah, floater before not working, but able to really fight for that ball. Gets a couple foul shots at the line. Sinks the first one there.
Jamie Gordon found herself a spot on the court she wasn't too pleased with, but the broom will not be necessary as we'll keep this thing underway. Second shot from Vallejo won't go, and it's Gordon with the rebound. Finds its way out to Brown. Over midcourt for the Hawks. Here's Giles. Kicks it over to Lopez. Back to Giles. That one broken up and able to find Brown. She'll put up a three and it's good. As Humber regains the lead, a big shot there for Britannia Brown.
Britannia Brown really taking advantage of some light coverage there. Sinks the three, beautiful shot.
Now Sheridan's opportunity to answer that big three there by Brown. Once again, nice battle by Lopez to kick that out, but recovered by the Bruins.
That's a good foul there.
So that foul will go against Giles. She'll be charged with that one, and now the Bruins coming over and having a chat with their head coach, Sean Douglas.
I gotta say, I like that foul. Don't let Orlando take the easy shot. Pull that close in, let her earn those points, as they say.
Absolutely, so here's Camila Orellana on the line. And now it's Giles' turn, trying to extend this two-point Humber lead. Gordon finds Giles, finding a bit of an opening in the corner. No good, that three from Evelyn Anang. And now on the fast break, unable to go, good defense by Gordon. Nice hustle to bring it back.
Brown's really one of those key players for the Bruins. Can't let her get that easy shot. Good defense.
Absolutely. This back and forth contest continues with that pass interception. Nice work by Brown to tip that one off Sydney Jarvis.
Jarvis showing some good hustle there. Even though she didn't come away with the steal, making Humber work for it here.
Yeah, both teams flying around the court so far. It's been a fast-paced one as you see Evelyn Anang control it there.
Time running out.
1 second to go on the clock. Giles puts it up and drains it. And that gets the crowd going as another big three-pointer. As Giles now starting to contribute on the scoreboard. It should be big for Humber. Nice play there as you see her rip the ball away.
That's going to be jump ball.
Brown.
Possession's going to stay with Sheridan there.
So we see this one slowed down a bit as AJ Schwarma is talking to the group.
Sorry, it was right earlier. It is Sheridan ball. A little bit of a mix up there.
See Sharma getting very active on that bench. Asking a lot of his defense here, and that's a nice rebound collected by Ebony Beals, and she's driving hard. That bounce pass out of the reach of Giles.
They knew they had time for one last shot there. Ebony Beals maybe trying to rush it there a little bit, trying to find Janae Giles open there. Won't work.
So that will do it in quarter number one, which was an absolute blur of a quarter. Fast-paced action on either side. But after one, it'll be 18-16 for your Humber Hawks. And Andrew, what do you see out of both sides in that hectic first quarter?
Well, I like the hustle. I like the hustle here from both teams, but we've seen a little bit of sloppy play from both teams here, really. None of these teams being able to really take control of the game. A lot of turnovers here, a lot of steals, some good defense, though. So it's been a very exciting game here so far.
Absolutely. We talked earlier about that high-paced action from Sheridan, averaging over 81 points a game. And we're going to see more of the same. You see Lopez with a three-pointer there, as well as Giles. And they'll look to continue that three-point shooting to keep pace with this strong offense that the Bruins bring here to the Hawks' Nest.
Yeah, the Bruins really came here as advertised. Look at their stats here. Their minutes are really distributed here evenly, not relying too much on one player. We've got a few replays here right now.
Absolutely. Well mentioned, Andrew, that depth plays an important part as we take a look at this replay here. A nice drive and a kick out to Giles. And she'll drain that three-pointer to get the crowd fired up. And
right at the end of the shot clock, too.
Absolutely. Beat the buzzer. It's a big motivation there for the Hawks as they start to get this crowd into one as they look to pull away from this Bruins squad.
Yeah, when you see arguably your best player like that, shoot a buzzer beater three there to take the lead. It's a huge moment there. Really get rallied behind that.
Absolutely. A nice crowd gathered here so far, and we expect more of the same for our contest later tonight. That is the men's game between Sheridan and Humber. That is the 103rd regular season meeting of those two clubs. Always a great rivalry. And we expect more of the same. Great basketball tonight. As we're enjoying quite the entertaining contest as we get back underway. Inbound goes to Taylor.
It's a lot of fun here. The crowd's really into it too. Oh, good shot by CJ
Campbell
there.
Johnson, who can do no wrong. Hits that floater there from the top of the key.
And not really being covered well there. She took advantage.
Speaking of covered, a wide open three taken there by Ashley McDonald, but it won't go. And the Hawks will regain possession.
Ashley McDonald, only a 20% three-point shooter, maybe purposeful by Humber.
Now Giles, long outstretched pass to Lopez. Back to Giles. Finds Brown on the outside. Looking to find MCJ in the key, unable to do so. Lopez with a wide open three.
Oh, nice rebound there by CJ.
You see MCJ there.
That's going to be traveling up and down.
Unable to get that shot off when she left her feet. This will be Sheridan basketball.
It's going to be a foul there.
Tanya Brown takes the foul there as Sydney Charvis rushed up court. Not exactly the ideal place on the court to take a foul. Kicked out there to Teresa Brown. Back to Charvis. Fakes the pass and puts up a floater. That won't go off the front of the rim. Campbell Johnson with the rebound. Quickly up to Brown.
Humber defense really making Sheridan work for their shots. Nice hustle.
Giles directing the offense here. Nice spin move. Puts up the shot. Won't go as it doesn't touch rim. Vallejo attempts to take it out for Sheridan.
That was a tough shot there for Giles. She just ran into a bunch of blue shirts there. Tough off-balance shot.
Teresa Brown against Jamie Gordon. Can't get that one to go off the backboard. Once again, Brown with an outstretched pass to Jamie Gordon. Just over her outstretched fingers.
A little too much on that pass.
AJ Sharma has seen what he needs to see out of his glove. He'll call a timeout and start to get some adjustments going. And I think it's very important to mention just the pedigree that AJ Sharma brings to this club. He's had 8 seasons with the team, a 2-time national championship, 2016 CCA Coach of the Year, 4-time OCAA champ, and 3-time OCAA Coach of the Year. And with a list like that of accomplishments, what better man to lead this Humber squad?
Yeah, that's quite the resume he has. And as you said, I don't think there's any better man that could lead this team right now. We've been doing a great job. And Humber in general right now, you can see they've really put an effort not letting Sheridan score inside, which is really their bread and butter. Really doing a good job in the inside defense.
Absolutely. Humber missing a couple key components of their strong clubs from years past, but Sharma really doing a nice job of bringing up this more youthful team, I would say, than the years past. And really showing strong here against some good competition.
Yeah, Humber, they got to a little bit of a shaky start at the beginning of the year, losing 79-51 at the opener at Fanshawe, but they really rebounded, destroying Niagara in Niagara, 73-28. And of course, last time out, they beat Lambton here in the home opener, 72-62. They're looking to build off that, of course.
And just a crazy note from that Niagara game. You mentioned the girls won 73-28. The Hawks went on a 45-3 run over the second half of that game. So if that can't show you the dominance that this Humber team possesses, I don't know what will.
Video game numbers.
Absolutely, that's an insane stat. Leha here for Sheridan finds Teresa Brown, guarded tightly by Giles. Nice work there to avoid a foul, and Lopez gets swarmed there by Bruins. The foul will go against the team in blue. Sean Douglas having a word with the official, getting an explanation.
I don't know if there's not much to argue there. That was a clear foul. Lopez headed up on her rear end there.
Giles, Campbell Johnson. Finding Giles once again. Trying to get something going here. 10 on the shot clock. Brown puts it up. Off the front of the rim, won't go. And look at Lopez there battling for every rebound. She seems to be all over the floor tonight.
Yeah, her game's really been something tonight. Team seems to be really rallying behind her. I don't even know how to put it, just how she's been playing tonight. She's been excellent.
Yeah, the firecracker. Standing at just 5'3", she is the shortest Hawk on the roster, but you've seen there absolutely no fear battling for those rebounds and getting in the dirty areas of the court. Find MCJ in the key here. She'll put up one off the front of the rim and out.
Another tough
and
shot.
A big steal by Britannia Brown.
She'll
a nice play, unable to get the layup to go, but was fouled on the play. She'll find her way to the line.
As we said before, Britannia Brown, not someone you want to send to the free throw line. 83.3% shooter coming into this one. Already sank a couple free throw shots earlier on. She got another couple here.
Yeah, great play there with that steal on the inbound. Unable to get that layup to go, but did draw the foul. She sinks one of two here. Looking to take a 6-point lead, and they will. Humber finds themselves ahead 21-16 here, 7.5 to go in the first half here at the Hawks Nest. That ball in there to McDonald. She works against Gordon. Finds Tanya Rowe. Back to McDonald.
Nice steal.
Now it's taken away by Brown, who's been busy in the last few minutes. She'll kick it out to Lopez, but that's stealed by Martin. And she'll outweigh Lopez and sink that layup.
Lopez there may be a little overeager to get that block.
No time wasted as that's down to MCJ at the baseline. And she puts it in off the backboard for a couple big Humber points. Back and forth action here on the court. Martin out with the ball, settles things down. In the corner to McDonald, out to Teresa Brown. That one won't go. Once again, Brown with the rebound. 3-on-1 here, and it's the one that wins as Brown gets a hold of that one. But a swat there from Sydney Charvis onto the arms of MCJ. She appears to be shaken up currently on the court.
A little trouble getting up there, but looks like she's going to be fine.
Seems to be able to smirk that one off as she's helped to her feet by Giles and Gordon. Tough foul taken there, but when you put up the offensive numbers that MCJ has put up this season, you got to expect some tough defense from the opposition.
Yeah, it looks like she's been a real focal point here, defending her for the Sheridan Bruins.
Lopez for three, won't go. Battle for the ball here. It's Gordon that comes up with it.
That's going to be a jump ball.
Still
Humber
fighting.
Ball. Love the fight here from Humber early
on. Absolutely. That's Courtney Martin and Jamie Gordon going at it on the floor as the intensity starts to pick up in this one.
This rivalry really living up to the billing here tonight. Both these teams do not like each other. They're making that explicitly obvious here.
Yeah, we are a short ways into this season. The intensity is at a mid-season high as these teams, as you mentioned, Andrew, are not too fond of each other as Lopez misses that three-pointer there. And it's Rowe finding her way up the court, battling with Lopez there. And Lopez will take a foul. Good aggressiveness shown by Tanya Rowe as she battles her way to the rim and draws that foul from Lopez.
Lopez, they're not happy with that foul. Rowe about to shoot two.
First one with a favorable bounce.
Rowe, not the best free throw shooter, shooting 57% on the season, but sinks the first there.
And that'll raise the percentage as she sinks two. Jamie Gordon inbounds to Lopez. Back to Gordon. Finds Giles. To the baseline. Putting it up. That's a Nang. Misses that one. Back up is Teresa Brown. Battling hard against Giles. It's number three, Courtney Martin.
She'll be called for traveling. Another turnover here. What do you know?
That ball inbounded to Giles. Battling against Black is MCJ. She'll draw that foul. Nice work by MCJ under the rim.
Yeah, she's been a real threat there underneath the rim, both for the rebounds and scoring-wise. Of course, as we mentioned before, Sheridan really picking up on that.
And that first one is short off the front portion of that rim. Makes good on number two. That'll pull Humber ahead by five once again. So long. Outstretched pass to Rowe. And she'll get a floater to drop. A full court press there by Sheridan, but that doesn't affect Lopez. She's able to get it out. That one intercepted by Teresa Brown, all in alone. We'll get that layup to go for Sheridan. And all of a sudden, it's a one-point contest as Humber getting a little sloppy with these passes here.
Yeah, they gotta be careful.
That one's deflected out of bounds.
Humber not too long ago had a six-point lead. Sheridan cutting that down to one.
Basketball, as always, a game of runs, and we're seeing it here.
We'll get a replay here to show you guys. Excuse me, we won't be getting that going as we get the play going.
Campbell Johnson doing battle with several Bruins there.
They should go to the line again.
So MCJ, who has found her points on the score sheet any way possible this year, seems to be doing it tonight on the free throw line. So once again, she finds herself at the charity stripe. Little problem there on the lineup as Gordon standing beside Valeja. A little issue there, says the referee. Two for two goes MCJ on the line for that attempt. It's a three-point ball game. Valeja for Sheridan. Down low to Rowe.
Sheridan getting called for traveling again.
I believe that's Rowe once again who's had an issue with that. She's been showing great aggression, battling her way aggressively to the rim, but needs to be aware of that traveling issue.
Yeah, that's the third traveling call, I believe, for Sheridan here tonight. Becoming a little bit of an issue here.
Hard pressing defense here by Sheridan. Opens up the floor. It's Brown to Lopez, a three, and it's good.
Oh, and she's going to make you pay when you leave her that wide open for a three-point shot.
Absolutely. We've seen Sheridan doubling up Giles there at the top of the three-point range, and that let Lopez wide open for that three-point attempt as Rowe kicks it out to Valeja. She'll work away into the rim, and a big block by Giles. And slowly but surely, you see the intensity ramping up in this one.
Oh, yeah. Not even at halftime yet. I mean, you can really feel the pressure from either side here.
It's been a real battle as we look forward to the rest of this one. Shot clock winding out. Can they get the shot up? They won't. And it wouldn't go anyways. It's Lopez now on the break. Finding Brown. Wide open three. No good. So that'll miss right. Had all day to shoot it, did Britannia Brown, but unable to get that one to go.
Yeah, still good shot selection there. Left wide open there from the three-point. Just a little too long there on the shot.
Sheridan not being tentative whatsoever on the defensive side of things, willing to let open shots go up to double team certain
Hawks.
Nice
steal there by Lopez.
As the Energizer Bunny of this contest, Lopez strips that one away and finds a Hail Mary pass to Ebony Beals. MCJ for the top of the key won't go. Rebound corralled by McDonald. She'll take it herself all the way to the baseline. Kicks it out for a three, that won't go. And that rebound unable to be corralled by any side. Off Sheridan, says the referee, and that'll be Humber basketball.
Rare miss there from the three-point line from Sydney Chavez. 40% shooter coming into this one. Left wide open there from the corner. A little uncharacteristic from her.
All right, timeout called there by AJ Sharma. So the Hawks will look to regroup here. Here's a replay. That free throw made by MCJ as she's starting to turn it on here late in the first half. Yeah, and as this game continues, the crowd really starting to pack in here for this contest as we always look forward to Sheridan finding themselves into the Hawks nest.
Again, as we mentioned before, this is a pretty massive rivalry for both these clubs here. And of course, people starting to come in, really feeling the excitement here. And of course, later at 8 o'clock, we will have the men's action here, which promises to be a great affair.
Absolutely. Be sure to catch that men's game. Tip-off set for 8 p.m. right here at the Hawks Nest. That'll be called by our good friends and broadcasting partners, Matt Hamill and Kyle Dalton, will have that one ready for you. And you look at the Bruins' all-time record here at the North Campus Gym. It sits at 4-10 all-time, so Humber has had their number for the most part in the series, but last time out, Humber absolutely cruised to 104-62 win back on January 25th.
I don't think we'll see a win quite as impressive as that one, but this game should be, or promises to finish greatly at least.
Looking forward to the conclusion of this one as these two teams are doing battle here. Just a 6-point game in favor of the Hawks. It's Giles with the handles, finding MCJ. She'll work her way into the key. Can't get that one to go. That rebound off the hand of Beals. Back to MCJ, kicks it out to Lopez. And she's been hot from 3-point range, but can't get that one to go as it's brought back up. A layup attempt there from Charvis. Won't go. Now it's Rowe with the ball kicked out of her hands from Lopez. And look at Lopez with the fight that she's had tonight. Battles it away from the larger Bruin. Showing the fight and spirit so far tonight for the Hawks.
Yeah, with the college rules, that with the jump ball there, we'll go back to Sheridan, but you gotta love the fight there from Lopez. She's been all over the place here tonight.
Five remaining on the shot clock. Brown puts it up. Unfavorable bounces, that's in and out. It'll be Brown taking it back over midcourt for the Hawks. Finds Lopez. Screen set there by Ebony Beals. Lopez finds Giles. She'll put up a three. Won't get it. Ebony Beals battles for the rebound. Does not get it. Teresa Brown takes it out. That layup won't go for McDonald.
Good defense there by Lopez.
Back out to Brown. That one won't go as well. It's Lopez now up to Giles.
Good interior defense there by Sheridan, not letting Giles get the easy shot there. So they bring it here the other way.
Charvis to Rowe. Open shot. Off the back, the base of that rim, and it kicks back out to Lopez. She'll slow things down here for the Hawks. Stop and play there for a foul called.
Courtney Martin's gonna get called for the foul here. CJ's gonna shoot two. As Humber is in the bonus right now, so any foul that Sheridan takes will lead to Humber free throws.
So you see Courtney Martin check into the game there for Sheridan. She finds herself back into this contest, and it'll be Britannia Brown who checks out for Humber.
This is new territory here for Humber. They've never led more than six, and they're up here by seven. That's eight now.
Once again, that's AC MCJ on the line. She puts up another two big points as she's starting to fill up that chat stat sheet rather quickly. Battle for that pass there between Taylor and Charvis. Foul called on Taylor.
A little bit too aggressive there on that one. She's gonna get called for the foul. Humber still has a couple fouls here to work with, or one more after this, excuse me.
Teresa Brown goes inside to Valeja. Back out to Charvis, shot clock running out. That shot is up and the rebound is collected by Beals. Looking for something to dish off to. It'll be Brown in the middle, surrounded by Bruins as MCJ kicks it out to Lopez, over to Giles, and that 3-point won't go. Martin now for the Bruins. And that awkward layup attempt there is in and out, but will draw the foul. That'll go on number five, Britannia Brown. So to the line goes Courtney Martin. First free throw attempt, good.
So Humber just ran out of fouls to give here, so they gotta stay disciplined here last minute and a half.
Absolutely, been a little bit of a chippy affair thus far. Foul's definitely something to keep an eye on as MCJ corrals that low to Ebony Beals. Good defense there by Vallejo.
If you're Humber right now, you just want to finish up the half strong. You're up by six here. You want to either extend, you want to probably extend that lead, I should say. Then don't let Sheridan come back into this one.
Absolutely. Humber trying to pull away late here in the first half. Difficult to do so against a strong Bruins squad. It's Brown will put up the shot. Couple bounces high off the rim, won't go. And Giles absolutely rips that out of the hands of Vallejo.
She looks like she's in a little bit of pain there. She fell hard to the ground.
Appears though she came down hard on that knee.
Just looks like she'll stay in this one.
Didn't want much to do with the trainer. She looks willing to shake that one off.
She's going to come out of the game right now.
Possibly not. She'll come out and will be replaced by number seven, Ashley McDonald. You see Orellana exit this ball game with that injury. That would be a big loss as she's been a rebounding phenom for Sheridan. Last minute of play, MCJ from the key, won't go, collects her own rebound, spin move, that one off the rim. Vallejo battling here, kicks it out to Brown.
2-for-1 opportunity here for Sheridan. Let's see what they do here.
Vallejo pulls up at the top of the key, that shot won't go. Rebound collected by Campbell Johnson, but stolen by Charvis, finds Brown. Shot put up and airballed by Courtney Martin. As the Hawks now, Giles works her way back up court. 20 seconds to go in this half. MCJ corrals that, looking to find an open teammate. It's Jamie Gordon just outside the key. 8 seconds remaining, that ball tipped away by Charvis. And that's not the possession that Humber was looking for, as Giles has a word with her team.
And if you're Humber here, all you want to do is get a quick shot set up here, and they got to take it off back on defense, get one ready to go.
So let's see what set play is set up here. It's Gordon back to Giles, and that one's good with just 3 seconds remaining on the clock. And that'll do it for half number one. We close with a big three-pointer there by Giles. And look at Humber in a hard-fought contest, really starting to pull away here as they hold a 9-point lead over the Sheridan Bruins. And Andrew, what has Humber done well in order to gain this first half lead?
Well, I think it's really all started here with Leticia Lopez. She's been a real spark plug here for them, just all over the court. Love her aggressiveness. It's really been inspiring your team here tonight.
All right, so we'll have a break here for half. Entertaining matchup.
Thank you. a bang out session.
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah.
Leaders, it's Maya Campbell Johnson with 11 points for the Hawks, and tied with 6 points is Courtney Martin and Tamia Rowe off the bench for Sheridan as we're underway here. It'll be Teresa Brown to get things started. She'll drive the lane, and that two will roll out. And up to Lopez, go the Hawks. Lopez over to Taylor. She finds herself stuck, but able to get it out to Campbell Johnson. That rebound corralled by Sheridan. That's Ashley McDonald. Charvis now driving through multiple defenders. Campbell Johnson gets a hand on that one, but it'll be a foul. Charge to Giles. Now Charvis will find her way in the charity stripe.
Giles' second foul here tonight.
Charvis averaging 15.3 points per contest so far this year for Sheridan, but nice work by the Hawks defense. She's held to just three.
That was a little bit of an uncharacteristic miss there from the free throw line. She's usually a really good shooter, 75% from the line.
So now Taylor will bring it up for the Hawks. Hawks currently with their biggest lead in the ball game. Three put up by Taylor, won't go. Rebound corralled by Orellana.
Gordon almost had it, just couldn't quite get her fingers on it.
Teresa Brown now kicks it out to Vallejo, back to Brown. She'll put up a three. Rebound corralled by Orellana. Vallejo, that one won't go either. It's worth mentioning with that shot there, Teresa Brown moves to 0-4. From three-point range, she's been unable to get that long ball to drop for her today.
Yeah, Humber doing a real good job making her work for those shots, not giving her anything to work with inside. Instead, she's adapting by relying on the outside shot, which has not worked here tonight so far.
Here's MCJ doing battle with Teresa Brown. Brown, good D here to hold MCJ up. Looking for Giles. That shot blocked by Charvis. Jamie Gordon battling there for the ball. Unable to wrestle it away from Orellana. Teresa Brown thought about the three, but pulls up. Martin now. Back to Brown. Top of the key. And it's good. That'll go. And that's 7 points on the board for Brown thus far. She's third in the province in per game scoring with 22.3.
Yeah, she's not someone you want to get going here.
As Campbell Johnson puts that shot down. As we mentioned, Brown uncharacteristically struggling a bit today. Unable to put too many points up. Credit to the Hawks defense as she misses another jumper there.
Yeah, Hawks really making her work for it tonight.
Here's Lopez, kicks it out to Giles. Giles over to Taylor. Taylor between two defenders, unable to get that roller to go. It'll be a push against Priscilla DaCosta.
Almost an end one play there, but I think she'll settle for the two shots.
Taylor sinks number one for the line. We see Sean Douglas there, the head coach from Sheridan. No stranger to the program. He played on the men's basketball team for 5 years for the Bruins and also was a key contributor on the team in 2007-2008 that won the provincial championship. Sean Douglas took over for Willie DeLay, who spent 6 years with the program and ended a two-year playoff drought last season. So big shoes to fill with Sean Douglas, but his team off to a 4-0 start. So far, so good for Douglas and his squad this season.
They're in danger of dropping their first one here tonight. As Humber here leads by their biggest lead here of the night, up by 10 here.
Absolutely, both teams definitely in for their toughest test of this young season tonight, as each two programs have a history of excellence in women's and men's basketball.
Nice offensive rebound there by Taylor. And she
that pass
it.
By Taylor intercepted by McDonald, and it'll be Brown that works her way back up the floor. kicks it out to Martin on the baseline. She'll work her way under the rim, out to Rowe. And she'll drain a mid-range jumper as Sheridan clawing back into this one. It's an 8-point lead now for Humber.
Sheridan really having to rely on their bench to get some scoring. Courtney Martin and Tamia Rose really leading in that regard.
Here's Lopez for three. Won't go. Rebound there by Charvis. That pass deflected by Giles to Rowe. Martin there finds McDonald. No shot, says the referee, as it appears that foul going against Giles, much to her dismay.
Yeah, she won't be happy with that one.
As Giles gets some clarification from the referee, it'll be Sheridan basketball. Courtney Martin will have the inbound here for the Bruins.
And Giles has got to be careful. Her third foul now. She takes another one, she'll be in definite foul trouble.
Giles comes down hard with that rebound, but able to get it up the floor. Now Taylor working against Brown. And she'll draw the foul there. That foul will be charged to Teresa Brown. So in what's been a quiet night for Teresa Brown, as we mentioned, one of the province's leading scorers, she'll need something special tonight to pull her team out of this hole they find themselves in as Jamie Gordon chucks up the three, and that's off both sides of the rim and kicks back out. Here's Martin.
Sheridan's got to be a little careful here. Only three and a half minutes into this quarter, and they've already taken three fouls as a team. A couple more, they'll be in the penalty, of course.
That's a good point, Andrew. We mentioned as this energy, this intensity ramps up, fouls are definitely something to keep an eye on here.
Yeah, Sheridan maybe feeling the pressure a little more here than they were in the first half.
Brown bumps off Gordon. The foul will go against Gordon. That'll put Teresa Brown on the line.
The foul's actually going to be charged to Lopez there, interestingly enough.
Good eye there, Andrew, as Lopez takes that foul. Humber currently sitting at 2-1. Sheridan with a flawless 4-0 record, but that is in danger tonight as they find themselves down here in the second half, that is. MCJ with the ball now. Taylor in motion. Nice play by Teresa Brown to strip her, but who else but Lopez able to find a way to that ball. Giles puts up the three and nails it. That's another one for her as she's continued her strong night from three-point range.
At corner three, excellent shot to take there. Humber back up by 10.
Martin for three. She'll get that one to go.
Nice little back and forth there.
Absolutely. These teams going shot for shot currently. And what was billed as an exciting matchup is absolutely living up to the billing as Taylor kicks it out to Lopez. Got it.
And she wasn't going to miss again. She missed her last couple three-pointers, but she sank that one to put Humber back up by 10.
Lopez continuing this three parade. It was Giles. And now Lopez, who drank threes from Humber. Sheridan adding a three of their own as that layup will not go for Brown, and Taylor settles this one down to what's been an offensive flurry early here in the third quarter.
Yeah, that was some good defense there by Gordon, not giving Teresa Brown that easy shot there. She's really been contained.
Giles again won't go. MCJ with the rebound to Jamie Gordon.
Oh, just spills out.
She was ready to run back to the defensive side of the court, but that one just rolls out as Teresa Brown puts up a mid-range jumper that misses short.
Not a great shot selection there by Brown. On the run, stopping to take that shot. That's not an easy shot to make.
Absolutely, that's a low percentage play for Brown. As Sharma barks out orders to his offense, and that's Lopez with a nice move there to find her way in the lane.
Oh, man.
And gets that layup to go.
That's now 11 points for Lopez here.
Missing an offensive assignment there are the Humber Hawks, as leaving Mara Douglas wide open. She drains that shot. Seen Lopez call for somebody to block that open Bruin, but unable to do so, as she'll corral the ball here.
Humber just trying to pull away with this game now.
Taylor from the top of the key. That'll miss, unable to get to her own rebound. Outlet pass to Rowe. Lopez chasing, unable to get to her. And Rowe, without looking, deflects that inbound, but it is corralled in by Giles. So we are currently at a breakneck pace. Lopez, a little bit of a heat check there as she seemed to not miss a thing from three-point range, unable to get that one to drop. Teresa Brown here for three. And that'll go.
I think that will only count. Oh, no, that will count for three. It looked like her foot was on the line, but that will count as a three-point shot.
And that's the first three-pointer made today for Teresa Brown as she struggled from beyond the arc. But a big block there on MCJ. Not many people could say that. As two of the top players from each side do battle there at the baseline.
Campbell Johnson really just not able to get things going as she had it going in the first half. Sheridan really making an effort to defend her hard.
And MCJ getting a little taste of her own medicine there as she currently sits third in the province with six block shots. And Humber actually leads the entire OCAA with 3.3 blocks per game.
And we've seen they're living up to that with three blocks here already. Janae Giles, of course, with two, and Jamie Gorin with another.
Absolutely. No easy points given out on either side of the basketball, as the coaches will have some adjustments for their side here.
Yes, it's been a nice little defensive affair we've seen here tonight. Neither team really been able to run away with it. Humber, of course, having the 10-point lead. That was their biggest of the night. Sheridan hasn't led since the 4-1 mark in the first quarter when they were up by three. They're going to try here to claw back into this one as Humber will look to extend their lead and hopefully try and put this game away.
Yeah, a little bit of a similar storyline to as we saw against their last home game against Lambden, as they kept the lead the entire game but really unable to pull away from that opposition, as Lambden, who dropped that game, a 72-62 decision, but they were able to stay in that game to the bitter end. And looks like we're seeing some more of the same tonight, as Humber really seems to have control of this game, just unable to pull away from this feisty Sheridan Bruin squad.
Yeah, the first quarter was really tight affair. It's really no team was able to run away with it there. Humber really taking control of that second quarter, and it looks like the third quarter will be more like the first quarter, a lot of back and forth action here.
That ball finds its way to Lopez. Screen set by Ebony Beal.
Oh, tough shot.
Jamie Gorin with the big rebound, but that's wrestled away by Valeja. Martin will bring it up on the fast break. Euro step. Doesn't get that one to go. Seems to have injured her knee. Seems to be in a lot of pain here.
Oh, no.
An awful thing to see. The last thing we want to see is the trainer gets out quickly there. So we wish all the best there for Courtney Martin. She went up against a couple defenders there on that fast break layup attempt and seems to have either rolled up an ankle or possibly twisted a knee on the come down. And we'll have a break in action here as we wish all the best to Martin.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate here for Sheridan. Martin had really been one of the key contributors here for the Bruins.
So as trainers tend to Martin here, we'll take a look at the standings, and right at the top, sticking out like a sore thumb, that's Sheridan, as they are currently tied for first with U of T, Mississauga, and Humber a little way down the standings at 2-1, but they have won their last two. They dropped their opener against Fanshawe. So, and what have you seen tonight? Humber has found themselves against a top-tier team and really seems to be putting on a show.
Yeah, a lot of good defensive play here by Humber here tonight. And they've been really sharing the ball here well, not really relying on one player to do the work all well. Although Campbell Johnson, Giles, and Leticia Lopez have really been key contributors here. They have been really leading the way here for the Hawks.
Absolutely. The usual suspect so far today for Humber, but the depth also coming into play. And a shout out to the depth of Sheridan, as their first half both of their first half leading scorers came off the bench, so they've been getting contributions up and down their lineup.
Yeah, it's sort of been their MO, just relying on depth more than anything. Their top scorers, Brown and Chavez, even though they are their top two minute getters, they really haven't, there isn't really too much of a divide there between them and the rest of their teammates. They've done a really good job distributing the minutes between the whole team there.
And a lot of credit has to go the way of the Humber defense. As you've seen, they slowed down the powerhouse Teresa Brown, holding her to her limited points. She's not on pace for her usual day at the office. And as well, this Sheridan team, who's leading the province currently with 81.3 points per game, and they currently sit at just 41. So definitely not the best numbers day for Sheridan, as they faced a very formidable Hawks defense.
Yeah, early on this really started. We saw a lot of turnovers, a lot of steals, a lot of feisty play from the defensive end. It's really translated into the whole game, really, where this has really continued and will probably continue for the rest of the game.
Absolutely, getting close to the end of the quarter here as we see some beautiful fan shots. We see a future Humber graduate there taking in the action.
Wearing those headphones, of course. It's a little loud in here, of course. The rowdy atmosphere for this big rivalry night.
Absolutely. You know, when Sheridan finds their way into the Hawks nest, it won't be a mellow affair, as the fans have been getting into this one all day long. And that will continue as we got the men's game coming up at 8 p.m. 103rd edition of the game coming up shortly on the Hawks Sports Network, called by our very own Kyle Dalton and Matt Hamill.
And you know they'll do a great job there.
They always do. As always. Trainers still tending to Courtney Martin as she finds herself struggling with a bit of an injury there. We'll keep you updated as to her condition.
It looks like she's going to be helped to her feet here. Crowd giving her a nice round of applause here.
Absolutely. The away gym showing their respect to Martin, as she's been an absolute warrior all night. It's heartbreaking to see her leave this game in this fashion, but she has to be proud for what she's done for her team tonight.
Yeah, it can't be easy for her or her team, seeing her being such a key contributor here for the Bruins, being helped off the court like that. Really unfortunate.
And we talked about depth on the side of Sheridan, and they'll need it here as they lose a key contributor.
Teresa Brown will take the free throw shots in place of Martin. She makes the first one.
Second one will go as well, so she adds to her unusually low score total. As we're back underway here at the Hawks nest, that pass intercepted by McDonald. She'll do battle against two Hawks. Can't get the layup to go, and it's Taylor who will bring it out with speed.
And Sheridan really turning up the heat here.
Absolutely. You've seen Chavez on the hip of Taylor. She worked her way up the floor, but she will take a foul.
Humber came out into this quarter up by 9. They took that lead up to 10 by a few points there. And Sheridan really climbed back into this one, cutting it down to 4. And this could be their quarter here if Humber isn't careful.
Yeah, Sean Douglas, the head coach of Sheridan, making some adjustments at halftime that really seemed to be paying dividends early.
Absolutely.
Taylor now to Beals. Back to Taylor. Behind the back she goes, looking to find Beals, unable to do so, as it's Brown. Gets the layup to go over the hands of MCJ. And all of a sudden, it's a one possession game, 2-point lead for the Hawks. Minute 50 to go in the third quarter. Into the hands of Campbell Johnson.
Humber needs some points here.
Kicks it out to the top to Taylor. Looking to drive her way to the rim, and does so. Nice handle shown there by Taylor. She gets that layup to drop.
That's just what the doctor ordered, as Sheridan was in danger of potentially tying this game. But instead, Humber will take the lead back to 4.
And here's Rowe now. Works away around Brown to Valeja. Chavez. And that 3 is good, nothing but net for Chavez as they stick around in this contest. It's a 49 48 ball game.
And Charvis, as we mentioned before, such a dangerous three-point shooter. And she makes the Hawks pay with that one.
Ebony Beals now inside MCJ. Gets it to go as the back and forth scoring continues. Sheridan looking to respond here. It's Rowe. And MCJ pokes that out of the hands of Rowe. It'll be Sheridan basketball.
Umber's got to do a little bit better job in the interior defense there. Even though they did prevent Rowe from scoring, they can't let her get that close inside.
It's an important point as Rowe has shown no fear driving the lane. As Vallejo puts up a shot, rebound corralled by Campbell Johnson. Over to Taylor. MCJ to Brown. Brown to Taylor. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Great work by Ebony Beals to fight that away, but she's blocked by Teresa Brown. Long pass out there to Charvis. That one rolls off the rim and out. Teresa Brown on the rebound. Kicks it back out to Charvis. No good is that three-point attempt as Britannia Brown comes down with it. And that will do it for an action-packed third quarter. Humber retains their lead, but it's only a three-point, one-possession contest here as Sheridan has found their way to battle back. And what has Sheridan done right, Andrew, in that third quarter to make this a very tight contest?
Well, it's all really started on defense, if you ask me. Did a good job getting in there, really preventing Humber from getting very many offensive possessions, or at least very many good offensive possessions, really getting in there, getting a lot of those steals, which we, of course, mentioned early on. They've done a good job, of course, getting Teresa Brown back into this game. She's really starting to heat up here and could be a big factor for Sheridan heading into the fourth quarter.
Absolutely, that's a good point made there on Teresa Brown. Really the MVP, if you want to say, of the early season for the Bruins. And she had a quiet first half, but really seems to be turning it on lately as she's had a few opportunities from the charity stripe. And she's really made her presence felt this game.
A lot of fouls there in that third quarter, especially a very feisty quarter. Both teams were both one foul away from going into the penalty. Of course, I expect that to continue going into the fourth quarter.
So we mentioned Teresa Brown there. She had a quiet first half with just 5 points, but she had a 9-point third quarter to really draw her team closer, and she's done a nice job getting herself back into this ballgame. Any stats that stand out to you from that third quarter, Andrew? You see Maya Campbell-Johnson here still remains the point leader for the Hawks with 16 so far in this matchup.
Teresa Brown really clawing her way back there. It's only two points off the game lead. I expect that to continue. She's really going to be a big factor heading into the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. She may have been able to hear us over here as we mentioned her slow start, but now she's really proving her worth as she's been on a show for the Bruins in that third quarter.
Absolutely, especially with Courtney Martin being out for this, especially having to deal with the loss of Courtney Martin there, who left with what looked like a knee injury. You're gonna have to, the Sheridan team's gonna have to do a little bit to fill in that role a little bit, as she's been sort of that sixth man for this Bruins team. That all important job.
Absolutely, so the Hawks will do their best to fight off this effort put forth by the Bruins, as in what was a 10-point game, now sits at just 3. You see Brown with the ball here, MCJ with the screen. Ball through the legs of Jamie Gordon. Corralled here by McDonald to Teresa Brown. Into the lane, and it rolls off the front of the rim. Lopez here with the fast break. Hawks have numbers.
Lopez, she has been really quiet there in that third quarter after she sunk that three. She's gonna have to get back into this one.
And what a pass there by McCabe Tabor. Taylor, sorry, as she finds Jamie Gordon, who puts that one up and in.
The Hawks back up here by 5. They're gonna look for a strong start here in the fourth quarter, hopefully extend that lead.
McDonald with the three, won't go. Rebound collected by Vallejo. That little hook shot attempt will not drop. So once again, the ball in the hands of Taylor as she finds Jamie Gordon. Britannia Brown Taylor in the corner. Takes a nice hop for the Hawks.
Talk about a friendly bounce there for Taylor. She sinks that three.
Absolutely, the hard work for Taylor paying off as Rowe battles her way into the lane. Cannot get that shot to go.
Good job by CJ to prevent Rowe from getting that ball there.
Here's the aforementioned Lopez kicking it over to MCJ. Tanya Brown now finding herself at the top of the key. Good ball movement, three put up, and three missed by Taylor. As Teresa Brown, the Bruins, will work their way back up the floor.
Taylor there was looking for the back-to-back three, just couldn't find it as she picks up the rebound here.
Taylor has been the general of this offense so far today. As they've been rotating through MCJ and Lopez. Once again, Taylor, the pace has slowed considerably here in the fourth quarter as Jamie Gordon has that ball stripped away. And Charvis now begins the fast break to Vallejo, to Brown, to the basket. That one's good for two for the Bruins.
Like we said before, Brown, she's going to be a real big factor here in the fourth quarter, especially if Sheridan's going to want to get back into this one.
Definitely someone to keep an eye on as Gordon kicks it out to Brown. Taylor near midcourt. Lopez in the baseline. She'll put up a shot, and she'll hit it. That's
open corner three for Lopez. And again, like we keep saying, she'll make you pay with that one.
We've seen it time and time again. When she has a moment to think and to double clutch that basketball, that shot's going to sink more often than not.
Yeah, watch out for her if she gets hot here as she comes down the court.
Speaking of Lopez, circles her way under the rim, waiting for reinforcements. She'll find Gordon in the post. Lopez on the baseline, kicks it out to MCJ, and it goes from the top of the key. A nice hop.
Beautiful assist there by Lopez to find CJ open for the easy shot.
Absolutely. Both sides seem to be running on all cylinders as that floater goes for Sydney Charvis. A nice shot there by the Bruins.
Floater, of course, one of the harder shots to make in basketball as you are off balance, but she made that one look easy.
Doesn't get any better than that. And if you thought fatigue would play a factor in this game, it sure doesn't appear so, as both sides, the girls have come out absolutely flying here in this fourth quarter.
Oh, both these squads are totally fired up here.
So with 6.5 to go in the fourth quarter, we'll take a look at this replay here. Some nice ball movement to Lopez on the baseline, kicking it out to MCJ. That'll hop in off the backboard.
Looked like everyone there was paying attention to Lopez and everyone just forgetting about CJ there. Of course, the top scorer for these Humber Hawks can't do that. And of course, she will make the Bruins pay with that shot.
It's a very tall task to ask of the Bruins to slow down the scorers of the Hawks, as we mentioned.
Yeah, but all these players for the Hawks have really been going, or at least a few of them, really going to Leticia Lopez, Campbell Johnson, Giles have all been firing on all cylinders, been really inspiring this Humber squad. With 6.5 left to go in the quarter, at the game actually, they're up by 8. And if they keep it up, they will prevent Sheridan from being undefeated here. And Humber will look, of course, to advance their record to 3-1.
I'm sure Humber would love nothing more than to take that 0 off the record of their rival Sheridan. Yeah, looking in good shape here as Gordon puts up a 3 that will miss everything. It'll be Sheridan basketball.
Yeah, Gordon not exactly knows a 3-point shoot, but we didn't left that wide open. I think I'd just chuck it up and take a shot.
Didn't appear as though A.J. Sharma was too pleased with that shot selection.
Oh,
as Lopez with the steal there. 2-on-1. Fakes the pass to Brown, but gets blocked. That's Ashley McDonald on the block on Lopez there. Nice ball fake. But McDonald was absolutely not biting. She got the hand up to block that one.
Yeah, it looked like Lopez was going to get the easy bucket there, but not so.
On MCJ down low. They'll kick it out to Gordon on the baseline. Nice ball movement there as Gordon slides from the corner in under the basket and gets that layup to drop.
And she made that one look easy, extending this Humber lead back to 10.
And Teresa Brown answers back right away with a jumper for the Bruins.
And what do you know? Teresa Brown back at it.
After not calling her name too many times in that first half. She's really made her presence felt here late in this ball game as Giles misses that three-point attempt. Brown once again with the basketball. Kicks it over to Sydney Charvis, finding Vallejo in three-point range. In and out goes that one.
Just rattles out. Could have been a big momentum swinger here for Sheridan. Would have put them back within five.
And they'll rule it's Humber basketball. So we'll get a break in the action here. Look at that last shot made from Sheridan. Giles now finds Gordon. Brown looking back to Giles. Looking for an opening. It's Lopez. Puts up the shot, but it won't count. As the foul will go against Charvis, a push against Jamie Gordon. Seen Lopez go up for that shot. Gordon lying at her feet. There's a reason for that as the ref rules she was pushed.
And Charvis here now in some serious foul trouble. She picks up her fourth. She's definitely not someone that the Bruins would like to lose here.
Hard-nosed defender, but definitely riding a fine line in this contest. It's Giles now slowing the pace. Nice play by Gordon to get a hand on that. It goes to Brown, but once again blocked, and once again it's Ashley McDonald. As Charvis will charge back up the floor for Sheridan. Teresa Brown. Back to McDonald. Put up a long two. Won't go. Ebony Beals gets a hand on it, but it's gathered by Sheridan. Charvis again. And that's a blocking foul. Charge to Jamie Gordon. That'll put Charvis on the line. Charvis now on the line, trying to get her team back in this. They trail by eight. Biggest lead was 10 for Humber early in the second half. And 2 of 2 will go for Charvis. Ebony Beals now finds Britannia Brown. Brown now doing work against Vallejo. Finds Ebony Beals. That shot blocked by Orellana. Beals again fighting hard on the baseline, but can't get her second attempt to go either.
Beals looking like she was almost going to make something out of that, just can't finish. Oh.
Sloppy ball handling there by Vallejo. She takes credit for that turnover.
Yeah, the ball just slipped through her hands there.
Yeah, you see her eyes just peek over, wondering where that next pass was going to, and just didn't get a handle of the ball beforehand.
It's a little bit of a brain fart there. Humber will take the ball.
With the speed this game is moving, those mental mistakes could prove costly.
Yeah, the speed here is really moving fast. Only 4 minutes left to go. Can't believe it.
This game flying by in front of a great home crowd here at the Hawks Nest. As Taylor drives her way into the key over to Gordon. Takes a bump but finds Taylor, who puts it in for two. 64-56, Humber leads.
And good passing there. Everyone find Gordon there for the easy two.
Nice save by Brown to Rowe. That pass deflected appeared as though off the hands of Gordon.
Good job to get her fingers on that pass. Don't give Sheridan anything easy here to work with as they look to claw their way back into this one. Humber, of course, up by eight with 3:40 left to go here in the fourth quarter as a timeout is called.
As you mentioned, timeout called by A.J. Sharma. As both teams will regroup here, and Sean Douglas has a tall task ahead of him. As he tries to make some adjustments to bring his team back eight. Down with only 3:40 left in the fourth quarter.
T- The clock is ticking here. Time is quickly running out here for the Bruins in this fast, very fast affair. And they're gonna have to look to claw their way back, get some shots in quickly. Maybe look for some three-pointers here as they look for a way to get back into this one.
Absolutely, that's a good point. The three-point shooting definitely on the side of Humber, as we've seen Lopez and Giles drop multiple three-pointers in this contest, which could prove to be the difference in what's been a fairly tight ball game the whole way through.
Yeah, Sheridan really not able to get those three-pointers going in the first half. So in the third quarter, they were 2 for 5, 40%. So the three-pointer could definitely be a factor here at the end of this game.
The Bruins will definitely need heroics. And I wouldn't look anywhere else than number 11, Teresa Brown. That's the task that the Hawks find themselves in, looking to shut down this high-powered offense.
Jarvis is going to have to be a big factor here, too, as she's open for three. Just can't put it away.
Good call, Ponyo Jarvis there, as she gets the first look on that three-point attempt, but cannot get it to go.
As we mentioned before, Jarvis is in a little bit of foul trouble here, so she's going to watch, going to have to watch her aggressiveness here in the late stage of this game.
Lopez now to center court. That's Giles. Back to Lopez. Giles to Taylor. Taylor driving hard in, finds Jamie Gordon. MCJ, familiar spot, top of the key. Cannot get it to go.
Taylor there trying to fight for that rebound, just can't get her hands closed on it. But looks like it's gonna stay Humber ball here.
Yeah, you gotta love the fight put up there by Taylor. She went hard in for that rebound. Gained her team possession. As Lopez finds MCJ wide open. And that's an easy bucket for her.
Another great assist by Leticia Lopez. They've been a little firecracker here today for the Hawks.
That one off the base of the rim. Rowe misses that shot attempt. Giles now trying to extend the lead for the Hawks. It's at 10 currently. Any points here on this possession would mean the biggest lead of the night for the Hawks. Taylor kicks it back out to Giles. It's good from three-point range. And Giles is having a day here at the Hawks Nest as she puts her team up 13.
An absolute huge three-pointer there from Giles to extend this lead to 13. The biggest here, of course, as you just said, here for Humber.
Vallejo with a costly miss on the three, as we talked about. Three-point shooting definitely in the favor of Humber.
Yeah, if you're Sheridan here, you can't afford to take many twos. Got to take the three and hope for the best.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Jamie Gordon able to find it with just 3.2 remaining on the clock.
And Humber really getting this fourth quarter going in their favor. As we're going to get a replay here for you guys.
Timeout Sheridan as we take a look at that deep three from Giles, ice in the veins. Late in this one, it appears as though Humber's pulling away.
Yeah, as we talked about, the first and third quarters were rather close, but the second and fourth seem to be more Humber's quarters over here. A little bit of a pattern developing. Humber, all they have to do here is just play some good defense, and they should be able to close out this game. Really,
absolutely.
Just watch for the three-pointers.
Just a hair under 2 minutes to go in this contest, and as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Humber unable to pull away from Lambton in their home opener, but I don't want to say anything too early here as we still got a couple minutes to play, but the Hawks really doing a nice job of putting the Bruins away here late.
It's really going to all come down to the top two players here for Sheridan, in my opinion. Brown and Chavez have to be their best players here in these final 2 minutes if they want any hope of coming back into this game. Numbers going to really have to make a real big effort in guarding them here.
Absolutely. Down 15 here, the Bruins find themselves. We'll need to go on quite the run. I doubt the Hawks would be willing to give it to them. As Lopez guards Chavez. Bruins working the ball around the perimeter. Nice D here shown by Humber, is unable to get an open shot. Deep three, won't go. Rebound to Ebony Beals.
That long shot there by Brown, that's one that the Hawks are perfectly fine with her taking that deep from three.
Once again, working the perimeter. Find Lopez off the screen from Beals. Lopez finds MCJ, five on the shot clock. Kicks it out. Giles driving the lane.
Oh,
and what was a pretty move to get to the rim, but unable to get that one to go. Crowd was ready to explode with that one.
Humber just did everything perfect there in that offensive series. Just couldn't get it finished.
And Lopez recovers that rebound. Nice high lob pass to Giles.
And Humber here's just got to run out the clock. Try and get some shots towards the end of the shot clock. They should be good.
We're in the last minute of this one. That ball rolls the way of Sheridan, but a nice block by Giles. And she'll find herself alone in the corner. Misses that one short. He'll dribble out of bounds.
Now there's still a bunch of time left there on the shot clock. Would have rather seen them hold on to it for a little bit more. But they're up by 15 here with just 45 seconds left to go.
And it looks as though Sheridan is going to have their first loss of the year, as that one goes right through the fingertips of Teresa Brown. And that might be all she wrote here tonight at the Hawk's Nest.
Yeah, it looked like Sheridan maybe defeating themselves there a little bit of sloppy play as they may have mentally checked out of this one.
Just 30 seconds left to go. Hawks look like they'll move to 3-1 on the season. Definitely their biggest win as they take down the 4-0 Sheridan Bruins.
Yeah, definitely a big statement win here for the Hawks. Coming in here 2-1. Of course, not looking too great coming into this one, losing the opener to Fanshawe. And besides that win to Niagara, that win against Lambden, really not, it was good, but not super impressive as they weren't really able to pull away. It's really been a great effort here by Humber here tonight. They're up by 15 here with 16 seconds left to go. And this one's just about over.
And Giles will find herself. Her apologies. Giles drew the foul there on a nice spin move to the basket. Inbound will go to Lopez. So the Hawks looking to close this one out as the ball is inbounded to Giles. Emily Beals find Taylor. Giles will probably look and wait for the last second to take a shot as Taylor puts up the three. Won't go. And with 2-1, that'll do it. Here from the Hawk's Nest, a huge win for your Humber Hawks as they beat the Sheridan Bruins by 15 here at home and move to 3-1 on the season.
Yeah, certainly an impressive win here for the Hawks here tonight. Big statement win against the 4-0 Sheridan Bruins coming into this one. Of course, dropping now to 4-1. Humber moving up to 3-1. Definitely a big win here.
The Hawks passing their biggest test of the early season with absolute flying colors as they pull away late from the Sheridan Bruins. Able to hold Teresa Brown to a minimal amount of points as the defense showed up in spades tonight. That's got to make AJ Sharma, the head coach, very happy with his club.
Yeah, this team really firing on all cylinders tonight. My MVP here today, I got to give it to Leticia Lopez. Really a spark plug here all over the floor, offensively and defensively.
And just as you mentioned, Andrew,
she gets mobbed there by her teammates.
Swarmed by her happy teammates, and it's nice to see. We see Courtney Martin back on the floor as she's here to join her teammates after that scary injury earlier in the contest.
Yeah, definitely, that was definitely the low point here of this game here tonight. She left this game with a knee injury. She's now out here on crutches, unfortunately. She was a big part of Sheridan for their game plan early on here today. And then when she left that game, they really weren't the same.
Yeah, big loss there for Sheridan. You see the girls make their way to the locker room, and out come the fellas as men's basketball will take on the Sheridan Bruins here coming up just shortly. 8 p.m. tip-off is scheduled as the 103rd edition of the game will be available on live stream right here on the Hawk Sports Network.
And this place is really filling up here right now in anticipation for this men's game. Almost no seats left here tonight.
So as the crowd gets settled in for game number two here at the Hawk's Nest,
Hi and welcome to the sideline. My name is Danielle Dupuy and I'm here with player of the game. We have, oh my goodness, you guys are just killing it out there. Where did that come from?
Honestly, it just comes from inside of us, right? Like AJ motivates us all the time saying like, how bad do you want it? We come in, we know what we're doing. It, it, of comes down to like who wants it more. We're down for the ball, getting the rebound, executing, late shot clock, late in the game, because we wanted it more.
So out there, Leticia, we saw you die for that ball. Now we have to ask, going into this season, do you feel like there's any expectation on the team?
Of course. This is a winning team. Like, we have a winning culture. Won nationals last year. The target's on us. Key players leaving. I think it's important that we stay composed, focus on new people coming in, focus on getting better, and just play our game of basketball. That's it.
That's perfect. Thank you.
Great interview there from Danielle Dupuy with Leticia Lopez. How we mentioned, was an absolute force, very deserving of the player of the game in that one, as she had quite the contest. So that'll all but do it here for us for women's basketball, a big 71-56 victory for the Hawks. We'll catch you later on tonight for the men's game right here on the Hawks Sport Network. For Adam Lusher and my partner Andrew Milani, thanks for watching. Have a great night.